In this video series, I'm recapping, in dramatic style, every issue of Fire and Stone, a comic series traversing the Prometheus, Alien, and Predator franchises across multiple eras. If you're not caught up, click the card in the upper right corner to check out the playlist with all previous episodes. Or just keep watching and you should be able to follow along. Today's video covers Fire and Stone Prometheus, Chapter 3. On the moon LV-223, Captain Angela Foster and her crew are on their way to the cave where they expect to find Francis and Eldon. Over the radio, she urges them to stay in the cave and await rescue. Unfortunately, they've already left the cave and do not hear this message. Francis desperately runs as a mutated Eldon chases him. Poisoned by the accelerant, Eldon tackles Francis to the ground and speaks to the man who once claimed to be his friend.
"Hello, Francis. Remember me? I'm Eldon."
Francis tries to apologize. "I'm sorry, I didn't know the accelerant would do this to you, Eldon."
"You mean you didn't care? I thought we were friends. Was I wrong?"
Eldon tears away the remains of his synthetic flesh and tells Francis that he feels smarter now. Smart enough to know the truth. Smart enough to tell Francis that,
"Even in this infinite universe, there's nowhere to run."
Meanwhile, Angela and her crew continue their way to the cave. They carry with them a canister of the accelerant. When Dr. Weddle asks if it's a good idea to bring along the dangerous black goo, Angela reminds him how valuable the substance may be. Then she refocuses them on the mission. "Everyone listen up. We are not here to engage any alien life forms. This is a search and grab mission. We search out Eldon and Francis, and then we grab them. Simple." As Galgo grins at the prospect of testing out his recently acquired alien rifle, Angela reminds him to try not to piss off any monsters. Back on the Helios command vessel, two crewmates enjoy coffee stolen from Galgo's bunk. Suddenly, a monster appears in the window next to them. A crewmate barges into the hall and shouts, "We're under attack!" Then he points to the window. "There, that's one of them! There are six of the bastards outside." They quickly radio Angela.
"Captain Foster, come in. The creatures you were talking about, they're at the Helios."
Angela orders them to seal all the doors and ensure nothing goes in or out of the ship. Then she informs her team they have a new mission: rescue the Helios. As they run in the direction of the Helios, Galgo's helmet is shattered as an alien monkey slashes his face. One of his crewmates clutches the monkey's grotesque appendage and shoots it in the face. When Angela checks on Galgo, he assures her it's nothing. Ladies love scars. As the crew gathers themselves, they detect a fast-moving human-sized life form. Finally, they are reunited with Francis. Angela quickly notices he is alone. "Where's Eldon? Isn't he with you?" "He's chasing me, trying to kill me." "What the hell for?" "He's gone crazy. Mutated. I injected him with some of that accelerant and..." Furious, Angela scolds him for injecting an unknown substance into a crew member and has him arrested for misconduct. Francis is baffled. "What? No! He's just a construct." Angela disagrees. "He's a member of our crew. He trusted you, and now we can't." End of story. Returning to their mission, Angela announces a new plan. They will lure the aliens away from the Helios using a surveyor vehicle as bait. As they make their way, Angela assures them, "We can do this, people. We're brave, strong, and we have all the power of the Weyland-Yutani Corp behind us." Reaching the Helios, they find the threat has grown worse. "What now, Angie? I mean, I didn't do much in college past stealing beer and pretending I wasn't the father, but I think that's more than six." Angela quickly comes up with a new plan. Galgo will take a small crew to another ship, the Perseus. They'll fly over the Helios and use concussive bursts to knock the aliens off the ship without directly attacking them. That way, they avoid damaging the Helios with stray bullets or by freeing the acid blood which the aliens carry inside them. Galgo assures, "Trust me, I'll be gentle. It'll be like I'm using a great big feather duster." Other crewmates join in Galgo's joke, saying they'll put on French maid outfits first. While they laugh, Chris only thinks of her wife who is currently trapped in the Helios. "Shut up, this isn't some damn joke." Now solemn, her crewmate assures her,
"I'm sorry, Chris. We'll get your wife out of there."
As Galgo and the small crew with him make their way to the Perseus, Francis continues defending himself. "Eldon is just a construct. This is like being arrested for breaking a tool.
You're just digging a deeper pit, Francis, another crew member tells him.
Galgo hears movement nearby. Approaching cautiously, he spots a towering humanoid figure, which seems to be carrying something. Shaken, Galgo returns to his crew. Although he does not know it, he's just seen an engineer. The engineer, seemingly unaware of his observer, drags an alien carcass, adding it to an already impressive pile. Meanwhile, Angela and her team spot a visitor approaching the Helios. A barely recognizable Eldon approaches the door, unbothered by the monstrous creatures surrounding it. As though recognizing some kinship with them, he offers assistance.
Are you having trouble with the doors? Here, let me open this for you.
He enters a code into the keypad, and moments later, the hellish creatures board the ship. Eldon cheerfully greets the humans inside.
Hello, my name is Eldon. It's good to see you.
After several attempts to reach Galgo, Angela finally gets through.
Galgo, damn it! Why weren't you answering? We need that bird in flight. Situation has gone sour.
She tells him what happened to Eldon and how he let the creatures into the Helios. Then she asks for an ETA, and Galgo responds.
Yeah, about that, Captain. We took a vote. We're in flight already. We can see this stretch of LV-223, and the whole damned jungle's alive down there. Those creatures are everywhere, coming out from their holes, coming out from the lake, coming out from God knows where. Thing is, we got out. It's too much of a risk to go back.
Too much of a risk? What the hell are you saying, Galgo? This better not be one of your jokes.
No joke, Angie. I could go into a whole philosophy and give you a long talk that would undoubtedly piss you off. But this time, for once, I'll keep the story short.
Good luck down there. And goodbye.
And that's where issue 3 wraps up. I thought issue 2 ended on a cliffhanger, but I've gotta say this one is even more of a nail biter. Anyway, let me know what you thought of the issue in the comments. Also, let me know if there are any other comics out there you'd like to see me give a similar treatment to. And if you enjoyed this video, please go ahead and hit that like button, hit the subscribe button, and hit the bell icon for more videos like this one. It's a huge help to the channel and gets me even more excited to make the next video, so I sincerely appreciate it. Thanks for watching, and see you on the next One Take.